Okay, as we know, capacitor is made up of two parallel plate and the plate are metal plate. So, dalam subtopik hari ini, kita nak tengok what is going to happen to the capacitor when you insert dielectric di antara the parallel plate itu. So, dielectric dekat sini is an insulating material ataupun kita panggil non-conducting material where there is no free electron available in the dielectric. Okay, so dekat sini ada gambar raja. This metal plate is representing your capacitor. And you have a dielectric has been placed between the plate of capacitor. So antara common examples of dielectric yang kita akan encounter dalam syllabus kita adalah rubber, glass, waxed paper. A very significant changes in the capacitor adalah when you insert dielectric, the capacitance is going to increase. The capacitance increase by the factor of epsilon R. Epsilon R ini dikenali sebagai dielectric constant. Okay, so we are going to look deeper into how the dielectric affects the parallel plate lah. Okay, so dekat sini kita ada your dielectric. Dekat dalam dielectric, what have you been made of is there is many molecules inside the dielectric. All these molecules are unpolarized dan mereka ini randomly placed. Sangatlah disorganized. So as you can see, kita ada banyak dipole dekat dalam sini. Each dipole ini ada positive, negative and they are very randomly placed. Okay, as you insert the dielectric into the capacitor, sebelum kita tengok kepada proses dia ini, kita fahamkan dulu, we know that your capacitor are going to have plates which are positively charged and also negatively charged. Betul? Satu positif, satu lagi negatif dekat sini. So, as you have a positive negative plate dekat sini, you are going to produce electric field line from positive to the negative. Benda ni kita dah belajar dalam last subtopic of chapter 1, iaitu uniform electric field in a charge, uniform electric field between the parallel plates. So capacitor is an example of a parallel plate dekat sini. So when you are inserting dielectric into the capacitor, apa yang akan jadi dekat sini adalah the dielectric akan make sure the molecules dekat di dalam dia align themselves. Maksud align themselves dekat sini adalah sebab bila dia dimasukkan ke dalam, dia akan experience that negative positive charge from the capacitor dan diri dia sendiri pun ada positif dan negatif di dalam dielectric itu. So dia akan align diri dia di mana all the positive charge on the dipole is going to be attracted to the negative plate of the capacitor and all the negative charge of the dipole being attracted to the positive plate. Ini akan menyebabkan mereka being aligned in a straight line next to each other and very organized. Okay, and as you can see, yang garisan ini adalah electric field line being produced by the capacitor itself. Okay, as you completely insert the dielectric, apa yang akan jadi dekat sini adalah, kalau kamu perasan, your dipole inside the dielectric has been aligned nicely di mana dia ada positive, negative, positive, negative. So dia akan produce electric field line dia yang tersendiri yang flow daripada positive of that dipole to the negative of that dipole. So yang warna kuning ni adalah kamu punya electric field line from that dipole in the dielectric itself. So bila kamu completely immerse the dielectric between the plates, apa yang akan jadi adalah the electric field from the capacitor dan juga electric field induced by the dipole moment dekat dalam tu are going to cancel each other dan menyebabkan a total of new electric field strength being produced between the plate. So sebab kenapa mereka boleh cancel dekat sini adalah electric field by the capacitor is opposite to the induced electric field. Electric field yang kita induce daripada dielectric itu berada pada arah yang bertentangan. So both this electric field are in the opposite direction, so mereka akan cancel each other. Tapi dia takkan cancel the whole thing lah. The capacitor has more electric field compared to the induced electric field. Therefore, kamu akan ada E from the capacitor is greater than E induced. Lepas tu dia akan cancel. And then kita akan ada remaining electric field between the plates from the dielectric. So kita akan ada E yang baru. E yang baru ini lebih kecil daripada E yang asal kita. So as you insert the dielectric due to the electric field induced is opposite to the electric field by the capacitor, they are going to reduce the new electric field strength between the plate. So kita akan ada electric field yang lebih kurang. According to our chapter 1, parallel plates, the electric field is equals to, uniform electric field is equals to delta V over D. So this is only valid for parallel plate dan dalam kes kita ini adalah parallel plate, capacitor is a parallel plate and as you can see your electric field reduce, E is directly proportional to your V, therefore bila E reduce, V akan berkurang juga. So now the voltage across the capacitor ataupun the voltage across the plate pun akan berkurang, will decrease. Menggunakan pemahaman dalam initial part of your chapter 2, C is equals to Q over V, which is the definition of the capacitance itself, ratio of the charge to the potential difference. When your V becomes smaller, your V and your Q remain constant, charge dalam charge yang kapasitor kamu store ini tidak akan berubah when you insert the dielectric in this case. Your Q remain the same. So Q adalah constant dekat sini. Therefore, we can say the relationship between C dan juga V adalah inversely proportional. So when your V decrease, your C is going to increase. Okay, this is why initially dekat depan sini Miss cakap, as you insert dielectric, the capacitance is going to increase. Sebab your Q is constant. Your V decrease, maka your C increase. Kita ada dua kes yang kita akan investigate dalam syllabus kita for the case of inserting a dielectric. Case pertama adalah where you disconnect the battery ataupun power supply, then the dielectric is inserted. Case kedua adalah you make sure the battery is still connected and then you insert the dielectric. So kita akan kaji dua-dua kes ni nak tengok what happens to our value of capacitance and how does this value changes. Okay, kalau kamu tengok for your first case, your battery is disconnected and then you insert dielectric. So before anything, you have to first charge your capacitor. So kamu akan ada capacitor kamu connected to the power supply in your circuit. And then you start the process of charging. As you charge, you're going to accumulate charges on the plate lah kan. So both of your plate is going to store the charge, satu positively charged, satu negatively charged. As you have completely charged the kapasitor, kamu akan ada maximum amount of charge being placed dekat sini, which is known as Q naught. Ini adalah paling maximum kamu boleh store. And then after that, what you do is before you insert dielectric, you disconnect your battery dulu. Maksudnya kita cabut power supply dekat sini. And then when you cabut the power supply dekat sini, you replace that with a voltmeter. Kenapa kita replace dengan voltmeter adalah so that we can read the voltage across the capacitor. So sekarang voltmeter ini akan bagi bacaan untuk voltage across this particular capacitor. Okay, so from here, as you can see, the charge in your capacitor is still the same. Charge dia tak berubah, masih maximum. You place the voltmeter and then the voltmeter is going to deflect to give a reading of a V naught, which is the same value as your power supply tadi. So katakan power supply kamu tadi adalah 6 volt. Kamu punya voltmeter sekarang akan bagi bacaan yang sama 6 volt, which indicates your voltage across capacitor is also equals to that particular reading lah. Then, awak akan insert dielectric. Before the process of discharging berlaku, kita quickly insert the dielectric. As you insert the dielectric dekat sini, awak masukkan dielectric di antara plate. What is going to happen here adalah the amount of charge that you have stored in the capacitor did not change. Dia tidak berubah, nilai charge kita masih sama dekat sini. Cuma, at this particular point, your voltmeter is going to give a different reading. So, bacaan sekarang dalam voltmeter berubah, dia tak tunjuk nilai V naught tadi iaitu 6 volt. Dia tunjuk a new value di mana the new value here is less than the V naught tadi. Your 6 volt tadi which comes from the supply. So, bacaan kamu berkurang. So, if battery is disconnected, then the total charge on the plate cannot change when you insert dielectric. So kita dah buang power supply, charge yang kapasitor itu boleh simpan tidak akan berubah bila awak insert dielectric. So your Q is constant but your V is going to decrease. Kenapa V decrease adalah sebab E kamu berkurang. Kita dah discuss pasal ni dekat atas ni. Kita cakap E from the capacitor and the E induced by the dielectric are going to cancel each other menyebabkan nilai E kamu berkurang. Oleh sebab itu V kamu akan berkurang as E and V is directly proportional menggunakan equation E is equal to delta V over D. So E is directly proportional to V. Therefore, your Q is constant, your V decrease, your C is going to increase menggunakan C is equals to Q over V. Okay, this is the first case. Ini paling basic. Alright, the next case adalah when you are going to insert dielectric but you did not disconnect the battery. Awak tak disconnect power supply kamu. So, first you are going to charge your capacitor first. Kamu akan ada capacitor and you connect to power supply. You are going to accumulate the charge on the capacitor. So kamu pun akan accumulate on each plate. Satu adalah positively charged, another one is negatively charged with a maximum charge which is Q naught dekat sini. So bila dah fully charged and then now kita dah fully charged, kita akan insert dielectric. Kita insert dielectric without removing the battery ataupun power supply. So circuit kita masih ada battery dekat sini. Kalau kamu perasan, bateri kita ni dia akan ada a particular voltan yang dia akan produce. So which is let's say 6 volt juga. So you still connect across the same power supply. So dia akan bagi 6 volt juga dekat sini. As you insert the electric, apa yang akan jadi adalah the electric field from the capacitor dan juga electric field from the dielectric akan cancel each other. So electric field kamu akan berkurang. Tetapi as you are still connected to the power supply, masih ada supply. So supply ini akan tetap bagi elektron untuk bergerak dan current berlalu. Contoh awak dah fully charge tapi electric field cancel. Betul tak? Bila electric field cancel, so electron dekat sini akan realize that there is space dekat situ, so dia akan continue to flow. Sepatutnya bila kita belajar charging process, completely charge, elektron dah tahu tak ada tempat dia akan stop untuk flow, betul? So current pun berhenti. Tapi dalam kes ini, sebab kita masih connect power supply, you insert the electric, the electric field line cancel each other, nilai electric field berkurang. So elektron akan realize kata, oh masih ada tempat kosong, so dia akan continue untuk bergerak. So dia akan fill up the new space dekat situ yang has been cancelled tadi. So what is going to happen adalah you are going to produce more and more charge sebab elektron baru mula datang. So when you did not disconnect the battery, battery is still connected. The charge in the capacitor as you insert the electric is going to increase. Okay, the charge on the plate will increase but the total voltage between the plate will remain the same. Kali ini V dia takkan berkurang sebab as you know you are still connected to power supply. So bila dia punya electric field dekat sini kurang, potential dia akan berkurang. Tetapi kamu masih connected to power supply, so power supply itu akan bagi balik. So kalau potential across the capacitor dekat sini berkurang menjadi 5 volt, apa yang kawan ni akan buat adalah the power supply akan bagi lagi 1 volt. Dia akan continue to give and give and give with the same amount. So nilai dia tetap sama 6. So dia berkurang dekat sini, dia bagi balik. Berkurang dekat kapasitor, dia bagi balik. Berkurang dekat kapasitor, the power supply akan bagi balik. So as you constantly providing the voltage with the same amount, the charge here is going to increase. Okay, so for the case of battery is disconnected, you insert dielectric, apa yang akan jadi adalah V kamu akan remain constant. V across the capacitor is still the same as V battery, but your Q is going to increase. Okay, menggunakan pemahaman kita iaitu C is equals to Q over V, you're going to have V constant now. Your Q is going to increase. C is directly proportional to your Q. Therefore, your C is going to increase as well. Are we good? Baru waktu jual tu, awak dah boleh letak dekat kamu punya apa nama tu? Capacitance. Oh, this is a particular value of the capacitance. So, you have your capacitance here. Parallel plate of the capacitance, they are going to have the same area. Both the plate are going to have same area. And one is positively charged, another one is negatively charged. There is space between the capacitor yang kita panggil separation between the plates ataupun distance between the plates. We denote it with the symbol D dekat sini. Okay, to find the capacitor, to find the value of the capacitor, we use this equation di mana C naught is equals to epsilon naught A over D. Apa maksud C naught dekat sini adalah the value of the capacitance. Miss guna subscript C naught dekat sini adalah just to differentiate that this capacitance has been filled with air ataupun vacuum. Maksudnya dekat tengah-tengah dia tempat kosong tu kita tak letak dielectric. Dia adalah kosong saja yang paling basic tanpa dielectric, air ataupun vacuum. So your C naught here is equals to epsilon naught. Apa itu epsilon naught? Dia adalah permittivity of free space which is a constant, mempunyai nilai 8.85 times 10 to the power negative 12. Okay, and then A dekat sini adalah area of the plate dan D dekat sini adalah distance between the two plate. Since your epsilon naught is a constant, you can have the equation of your C is directly proportional to your A and inversely proportional to the separation between the plates. Okay, so C proportional to the A, so kalau area increase, capacitance akan increase. C kamu is inversely proportional to the plate separation. So kalau the separation gets bigger, your C is going to decrease, semakin berkurang. Ini adalah for the case where the gap here has been filled with vacuum ataupun air. Kalaulah sekarang kita fill that with what is that called, a dielectric, apa yang akan jadi adalah that particular equation is going to change. So this is the equation for capacitor with vacuum. Okay, macam Miss dah tulis, C naught is equals to epsilon naught A over D. Let's say if you fill up that gap with dielectric, sekarang kita insert dielectric, your capacitance is going to have a new value. Macam kita tengok dua-dua case tadi, case 1 dan case 2, you insert dielectric, capacitance will increase. You insert dielectric, capacitance will increase. So sekarang kita nak cari nilai capacitance baru with the dielectric itu. Okay, so you can also find the value of capacitance menggunakan equation epsilon A over D. Di mana C ini adalah the value of the capacitance with dielectric. Okay, epsilon here is the permittivity of dielectric material. Ini bergantung kepada apa jenis material yang kita guna untuk dielectric kita. Contoh kalau glass nilai dia lain, kalau dia wax paper nilai dia lain, mica nilai dia lain. So it depends on what we have used the material lah. And then this is the area of the plate and this is the distance between the plate. Okay, so menggunakan these two equation, we can find a new term which is known as dielectric constant. Okay, awal-awal tadi, waktu kita tengok pada kapasitor with dielectric, kita cakap as you insert dielectric, the capacitance will increase. Yes, kita dah kaji dua-dua case. Case pertama, case kedua, kita tahu capacitance increase. But your capacitor is going to increase by a specific factor known as dielectric constant. Okay, apa maksud dielectric constant itu adalah your dielectric constant is the ratio of the capacitance with dielectric to the capacitance with vacuum. Okay, so your dielectric constant epsilon R ini adalah ratio of the capacitor with dielectric to the ratio of the capacitor with a vacuum. Okay, dua-dua dekat sini mempunyai unit yang sama iaitu farad. Therefore, your epsilon R is unitless, tak ada unit. Okay, dia tidak mempunyai unit dekat sini. Okay, so now I'm going to substitute my known equation epsilon R sama dengan C over C naught, di mana C saya adalah epsilon A over D dibahagi dengan epsilon naught A over D. You're going to use the same capacitor, cuma initially dia adalah vacuum, kali kedua adalah you insert dielectric, betul tak? So the area mereka sama, the distance between them is also the same. So your epsilon R here, dielectric constant here is also equals to permittivity of dielectric material to the permittivity of the free space. Ini bergantung kepada material kamu guna. Ini adalah constant iaitu 8.85 times 10 to the power negative 12 C kuasa 2 N negative 1 M negative 2. Okay. So, selain daripada dielectric constant is defined as the ratio of C to the C naught ini, iaitu capacitance with dielectric to the capacitance in the vacuum, it is also defined as the permittivity of dielectric material to the permittivity of the free space. Okay, menggunakan pemahaman-pemahaman kita yang lain yang kita ada dekat chapter ini, kita boleh also deduce your dielectric constant is also equals to, selain daripada permittivity of dielectric material to the permittivity of free space dan juga capacitance with dielectric to capacitance in the vacuum, dia juga sama dengan voltage across the capacitor in the vacuum to the voltage in the capacitor with dielectric. Begitu juga dengan electric field in the vacuum to the electric field with the dielectric. So bergantunglah kepada apa nilai yang dia bagi, dia suruh cari epsilon R, awak boleh pilihlah awak nak guna equation yang mana satu. Dua-dua ni pun ada cara derive dia, ada dalam nota. Awak boleh tengok balik dekat situ, very easy. Kita guna basic equation iaitu E is equals to V over D dan juga C is equals to Q over V sahaja.
Okay, there are a few advantages of inserting dielectric. That is why we insert dielectric in our capacitor. The main thing adalah is to increase the capacitance. Contohnya awak ada capacitance yang mempunyai nilai 1 microfarad. Tapi awak memerlukan 5 microfarad. So for that, what you do is you insert dielectric between the capacitor so that you can increase the capacitance. Selain daripada itu, dia akan increase in maximum operating voltage. Apa maksud increase in maximum operating voltage adalah dia akan make sure your operating voltage, which is the voltage from the supply, itu paling maksimum. Kita akan guna yang, kita akan increasekan dia up to the maximum usage itu. And then possible mechanical support between the plates, which actually allows the plate to be closer together without touching each other. So apa yang akan jadi adalah if you were to decrease the distance between the capacitor ini, kita tahu C akan increase. Bila awak decrease your D, your C is going to increase as they are inversely proportional. However, awak boleh kecil sekecil-kecil D kamu ini, sekecil-kecil D kamu itu, mereka tetap tidak akan bersentuhan. The capacitor will not touch each other. Due to that, they have possible mechanical support between the plates. Mereka tak boleh bersentuhan. They can come very close to each other, but they cannot touch each other due to that mechanical support. So this is the advantages of inserting a dielectric dekat sini. Okay, are we good up to this particular point?